Okay, Bingwei, you spent the last 2 weeks with us for your holiday, and it's coming to an end. How? What is your feeling?
I am feeling very happy and feeling very good because I didn't get beaten, and for once I had fun. And yes, I didn't have fun at his house because he don't have any gadgets, and even if he does have any gadgets, he won't allow me to use them. And when I'm at Dad's house, which is also Mommy's house, which is also some of us house, I get to play with an iPad, Dad's iPhone,
So during the 2 weeks when you are here, you will never get scolding from any of the adults here, man? Did you get any scolding?
Scolding, yes. Yes.
Why?
Because I was playing the games without permission.
Other than that, did you get scolding for no reason at all?
No.
Did you eat well, sleep well?
Yes, I eat too well. And I vomited because I ate too much sometimes. Not like vomit, just feel like...
During the 2 weeks, did your father try to call you?
Yes. My father tried to call me, and because today is the 24th of June, which is my birthday, he called me lots of times via mommy's handphone. But mommy didn't take the calls because mommy's battery was low. So mommy called Sanpapa to call him.
Now, during the period when he called, when you were here, did you manage to speak to him, and how did you feel when he called and wanted to talk to you?
Yes, I did manage to speak to him once, which is last week. Yes, that's right. Which was Wednesday, yes. And I was feeling very frightened because I don't know what to say, so I was feeling a bit awkward.
So when he called you that time, what did he ask you about?
Oh, he asked, did I sleep well? Did I eat well? And did I miss him?
So what was your answer?
I said I missed him, but in my heart, I didn't miss him.
Why did you say that? Why did you say you miss him, but your heart say you don't miss him?
Because I was frightened that he would beat me when I went back.
Now, after this trip, the 2 weeks here, when you go back, I believe that he will ask you a lot of questions on what you have done the 2 weeks here, where have you been, and all this.
Yep.
So, what would you do, or what would you say?
I would say, like, if he asked where we went, I would say we went to Johor, and we did lots of shopping, and we bought lots of things, and I'm very happy.
That's all?
And we went to lots of fun places.
Now, recalling the first Sunday that you were here with us, there was an outing together with your sister.
Yes.
Which is good to the five
attraction.
Cultural places in
Singapore.
Seven
Okay,
7 culture. Okay, 8 places that you go. Now, who were you with during the trip?
That's it, and him.
Did you enjoy the trip?
No.
Why?
Because I had no freedom, and once in a lifetime I get to go up with Tata to a far place by ourselves, and he ruins it.
And why did you say that you totally don't enjoy when he's around? What if the trip were to be attended by your mother and me? Do you think you will enjoy?
Yes.
Why?
Because I will have lots of fun.
Now, after that trip, or during the course of the trip, did he hold on to you as if, like, you know, you're going to run away from him, and then he doesn't allow you to talk to anybody?
Yes.
Okay. Now, you are going back this Saturday, okay, as part of the deal. And I had to fight him to make sure that you can go back at 5 o'clock, because he was telling me that he wanted you to go back at 7 in the morning. So I had to fight to gain your freedom and the extra moment of fun and happiness, as you call it. Now, at the end of the day, not too sure whether my effort is worthwhile. But when you go back to him, you got to be prepared for the worst. Because I know the situation now. Okay? He is broke. He has no money. Okay? And he has recently asked the counselor from the family services to force mommy to take your education grant to be handed over to him for whatsoever reason. We have refused, citing that we have placed the money into your bank account for your educational need. Now, if you have anything that you need from school that you need to buy, please tell your tete. Please tell your tete. You can tell him, but he can tell you otherwise. But you go and tell your tete, and I will look into your problem. Okay? Understand? So, again, I say, if you are not willing to help yourself, neither can God. Okay? And in the court of law, they always say, I solemnly swear to speak the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God. Correct? Have you heard that before? You have, huh? So, don't be a liar like your father. Understand? Whatever you do, whatever the thing is, if you have a problem with your father, you better come to us. You got to fully extend your emotion, how you feel about it, what he do to you, he smack you, he beat you, whatever, you come and tell us. We will look into it. Understand? Understand, huh? Okay, this video, I will keep a copy. I will put it in the Facebook. I will put it in the YouTube. I will show the whole world what your father is to you as a father. You know what he tell me today?
No.
On the phone? No. He tell me Why y'all bring my son go and play until so late? Don't let him come back. I tell him to that your child deserves moments of freedom and fun, and not to be treated like a jailbird, to be locked up in the home. And he goes like, yeah la, y'all can afford ma, that's why y'all bring him out ma, I cannot ma. That's not my problem, I told him. That is not my problem. I told him, if you cannot take it that your son have a moment of fun and freedom, okay, then what kind of father are you? You cannot give doesn't mean other people cannot give. Your son is like a caged bird, no? You lock him up there, and then when you let the cage open, he fly loose. He's like a mad animal like that, flying around. Why should you develop a child to become like that? Let him be free. Let him grow. Your father can never understand this. Your father can never understand this. You know why? Because of himself. Okay? Remember, I also got abusive father. My father beat me 7 days a week, especially Saturday, Sunday, confirm chop chop one. Even if I do good, also get beaten. But yet, I have never beaten children, not even when your tete is super naughty. Okay? So I never believe in beating a child to discipline them. I never believe in beating children to make them good citizens. Okay? So remember, don't forget. If you forget, it's not my problem anymore. Yeah?